Final domain, domain of culture. Now, if you're a primatologist, up to about 10 years ago, if you ever said the word culture in front of other primatologists, they instantly took your tenure away because it showed you were obviously not serious in anthropomorphizing. These days, there are two words that are the trendiest in primatology. The first is culture. The second is personality. These are both very relevant to non-human species. Culture as defined as the non-genetic transmission of behavioral styles to a next generation, we are not the only species that has culture. Chimps pass on styles of making tools. This 27 different variants of behavioral differences, regional behavioral differences in different chimp populations that are passed on as culture. A number of years ago in my baboons, I found an interesting example of this as well. And this was a troop where, for very complicated reasons having to do with proximity of humans, half of the males in this troop were killed by humans, and it happened that these were the most aggressive males in the troop. And what you were left with was a very unique situation where there were twice as many females as males, and the males who survived were these very affiliative nice guys, and this produced a completely different social atmosphere in this troop, one where there was far less aggression, everybody getting along a lot better. And here's one example of this. If you were a baboonologist, what I show you here is a lot stranger than if you discovered baboons could fly or with for photosynthetic or something. What we have here are two adult male baboons grooming each other. Male baboons do not do this except in this troop. And as new adolescent males join this troop, transferring them from elsewhere, they learn to do this. There is transmission of this cultural style. So we are not only the only species that can have culture building tools and microwaves, we're even not the only one that has cultural transmission of entire social atmospheres. So what's unique about us? What is obvious is just the Baroque, Byzantine, complex magnificence of human culture and what we're able to do with it. And we see here other species would wither in envy at a photograph like this, knowing that we are able to do stuff like this.